Morning students, today we will start our fifth experiment and this is useful for both electrical and electronic students. So the aim of the experiment is to study the speed control of DC shunt motor by armature control method. We have already discussed about the field control method in your previous experiment. So in this experiment we will understand how to control speed using armature control method. So here also you required some equipments, namely a DC compound motor, or you can also make it with the help of a shunt motor, a rheostat, a voltmeter, and the theory is, as we can understand the theory as in your screen now. The method is used when speed below the no load speeds are required. As the supply voltage is normally constant, the voltage across the armature is varied by inserting a variable rheostat or resistance in series across the armature is decreased, thereby decreasing the armature speed from the speed or armature current characteristics. Now here student, let us see the diagram, circuit diagram. As in your screen, you can see the field circuit. There is a armature tappings which is connected to the rheostat and is controlled by a rheostat. So by controlling the rheostat, we can increase the resistance always. We cannot decrease, right? So by increasing the resistance, the current will be decreased. So thereby the flux will be again decreased. So if the flux will be decreased, then the speed will be always decreased. So in this method, by using this relation, we will decrease the speed here to the no load speed. Now the procedure, student, here also you have to elaborate the procedure. We have discussed the procedure in a brief way. You have to elaborate it in past tense. All the connection were disconnected from the mains. Connect the rheostat in series with the armature control method. Before switching on, we should check all the connection thoroughly. And finally, the external supply was fed to the DC supply. You have to write the conclusion according to your observation. You have to write the conclusion and also you have to fill the discussion questions. Why or state application of DC shunt motor, state different types of control speed of for DC shunt motor.
Now student, this is the machine. Let us have a look to the nameplate. Now we'll also we'll have a look to its ratings of this rheostat. Rheostat rating is in, you can see it is 23 ohm and ampere is 10 ampere, right? Now student, before starting this experiment, let us understand what we are going to do. We are going to control the speed, and the speed is, or the speed which will run this machine will be below its no load speed. Now let us understand the connection. See, this voltmeter will be always connected in parallel. So I have taken two probes and these are connected across the armature because we are keen to understand the voltage across the armature. So these are the two terminals connected to A1 and A2. Now this rheostat will be connected in series. So from A1 I have taken a terminal here. The other terminal is taken to the main terminals. So yes, the other terminal is connected to the A2 terminals. So by controlling this, we can control the speed to its no load speed. Now Prakash sir will run the machine and he will demonstrate us how the control of the speed is exactly done in this experiment.
मैंने रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीज करमर मेजरमेंट कर एक मीटर फल के स्पीड अभी हूँ 1089 हजार अणानबे स्पीड अच्छे अभी मुझे जस्ट आम इनक्रिज करी कौन आम रिस्टार्ट्रे आम रेजिस्टेंस इनक्रिज करी देखिए आम कौन इम्प्रूव होमर स्पीड रे डिक्रीज होना इनक्रिज हो रेजिस्टेंस मुझे इनक्रिज कर देखिए आमर कौन स्पीड भी कौन है डिक्रीज हजार चालीस आमर वोल्टेज भी कौन वोल्टेज भी आमर कौन डिक्रीज हो गए हजार चौदह वोल्टेज भी कमी गला रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीज कर नौश पंचाशी
और हम वोल्टेज भी डिक्रीज हो।